Hey guys, I'm Pixel Dan, and this is a review of the Masters of the Universe Classics, Scorpia. It's a new member for the Evil Horde faction, as well as a first-time ever action figure for another Filmation-created character. Scorpia comes packaged in the Masters of the Universe Classics blister card packaging, fully showcasing the figure within and displaying an Evil Horde insignia on the package. The back shows off a selection of other figures in the line, as well as presents us with a brand new bio for Scorpia. Scorpia is one of those characters I've always wanted to see translated into action figure form. She just has such a cool look that is perfect for the Evil Horde, being sort of a human-slash-monster hybrid. She features brand new forearms with pincers for hands, something that really makes her stand out from the other females in the line so far. And of course, her backside features a scorpion's tail. The sculpt is really great here, giving us some new elements such as that scorpion tail and pincers, as well as a new tunic over the female buck featuring the Horde insignia over the belt area. The skirt piece is similar to what we've seen on most of the females in the Classics line, but Scorpius has much more of a curve to it, which better reflects the leotard look from the cartoon series, which I feel works really well on this figure. And the head sculpt is gorgeous, doing a great job of capturing the shape of her face seen in the Princess of Power cartoon series. I love the high eyebrows with the green eyeshadow going all the way up her forehead. The paintwork is nice and clean on this figure as well. The helmet and Horde insignia are a nice bright red lying against the black of her outfit, while her shoulders, pincers, and scorpion tail are almost more of a pink color, which is cartoon accurate and wonderfully translated. Alright, let's go ahead and take a closer look at Scorpia. Alright, very basic stuff as far as articulation goes. It's a lot like we've seen on all the other females in the line so far. So the head's on a nice little ball joint there. It can rotate it all the way around, left, right, up and down. The articulation isn't hindered even by the collar, because the collar's a little softer. So it does flex around. The head can still turn left and right just fine there. Same with the shoulder parts. They're very soft and flexible. So you can still raise the arms up all the way, move them forwards. Swivels at the bicep. Standard joint at the elbow, and you got swivels at the wrist so you can rotate the little pinchers there on her hands, which are awesome. Love the pinchers. You got a nice torso cut articulation so you can swivel her waist side to side. Of course, the suit that she's wearing is on the body permanently, so it's non-removable, but again, just like we've seen with all the other females so far in the line. Thighs can move outwards, forwards, and backwards. So she can get some great sitting poses, she can get some straddling poses for the horses if you want to. You do have the nice swivels at the thigh cut there, you got standard joints at the knees, there's no boot cut articulation, so there's no swivels at the calves there. But it does just have the standard up and down movement at the ankles, which does have the pin showing, but the joints are tight enough. I mean, they're not too loose on the feet, so she doesn't really have any problems standing or anything like that. As you can see, stands just fine. So the other thing we really want to talk about, of course, with Scorpia, is her scorpion tail, because where would she be without that, right? Now, the way that this is done is it's actually sculpted onto the loincloth piece. So you can see it's attached to that, not to the figure itself. In fact, if you look up under the loincloth, it doesn't actually attach to the figure. It's all part of that sculpt there, which means it's also made of the same kind of flexible plastic that the loincloth piece is itself. So you can see it's kind of flexible, and it does have one articulation point at the almost the base there, so you can rotate the tail left and right, but that's really the only movement we get out of it. It doesn't go up and down or anything like that, just left and right. And the whole tail itself is very flexible. It's made of that kind of gummy plastic, which is pretty nice, actually. I mean, it feels really good. It feels nice and sturdy, so I don't think you have to worry about it tearing or anything. Maybe in some of the smaller places, I'd be careful with bending it around a lot, but it works pretty fine, you know? I mean, it's got a good rotation there going left and right, and I do kind of like the flexibility, but you're not going to get a lot of posing out of it as far as just, you know, you can't do any over-the-shoulder strikes or anything like that. She's mostly just stuck with it looking left and right.
For an accessory, Scorpia gets her own Horde crossbow with a cool new look. Similar to what we saw with Octavia, this new crossbow fits Scorpia's personality by featuring a scorpion tail on the back and an overall insect look. It has a clip on the underside that snugly snaps onto either wrist, readying her for battle. So there you go, guys, a look at the Masters of the Universe Classics Scorpia. I'm really loving these Filmation female Horde members, and am so happy to finally be receiving them in action figure form. I loved Octavia when we got her, and I think I like Scorpia even more. She's been high on my wish list for some time now, and she definitely does not disappoint. Plus, this gives us more Filmation representation, more Princess of Power representation, and is really bulking up the ranks of the Evil Horde. That is one seriously threatening-looking team. Scorpia is part of the 2014 Club Eternia subscription, and will be available on MattyCollector.com on May 15th, 2014. Until next time...